So this campaign, you had much more money than last time. The Greens were obviously weak. Trudeau was potentially vulnerable. Your likability numbers far exceeded the likability numbers of your rival leaders. And yet, at this point, you have one extra seat, maybe a couple more. After this campaign, with all of those factors, do you feel secure in your leadership with that result?
Yes. To me, one of the really troubling parts about this campaign or this election has been that one of the reasons why we said Mr. Trudeau should never call it, he claimed that he wanted to hear from people. Well, this is the lowest turnout despite one of the biggest crises we've ever faced. And a lot of that is because there were some changes that we wanted to bring to the Elections Act that would have made it easier for people to vote that both the Liberals and Conservatives held up in Parliament and didn't allow to pass. And so what we saw was really discouraging to people. Really, really long wait times, really difficult access to voting, less places to vote, less access for young people to vote on campus. We were hearing really terrible stories. Folks saw the images. People in Toronto that are voting underneath the Gardiner, it's a really busy highway in the dark, having to line up underneath a highway in the dark to vote. These are not the conditions of how things should have been. We heard from Indigenous communities that were told if you got advance voting, you're not going to get a polling station on the day of the election. Like these are pretty bad things. Like we pride ourselves on being a democracy where we want to make it easy for people to vote. And what we saw was not that. And I blame Mr. Trudeau because he called an election without having laws in place that would have allowed us to make adjustments so that we could make sure there was easier ways to vote in a pandemic. And that was a huge failure on the part of Mr. Trudeau. I think the bigger problem that we're up against for us as a party is we believe that better is possible, that we can do better. And I think there is a lot of cynicism. And I think that cynicism has been fed by people like Mr. Trudeau, who said a lot of great things, and when they don't do them and people end up hurting because of that, it increases cynicism. And it's hard to imagine that things can be better. And I think that's really one of the biggest challenges we're up against is letting folks know or having folks really start to believe that we can do better. And I hope to do that. I hope to reinstill that faith and that hope that better is possible. We can make things better. We can fix the problems we're up against. If we make things a priority, they get fixed. And I want Canadians to know that. And so I'll keep on working on it. I am, though, disappointed. Of course, I'm disappointed that incredible MPs that we had, incredible candidates that we have, are not returning as MPs or not coming to Ottawa as MPs. I think that's a loss for our team, but it's also a loss for Quebec and for Canada and for the Parliament. So I'm disappointed. I'm sad to not see that Ruth Ellen will be back in Ottawa. I think she's already shown to be an incredible voice, would have been a great voice again. Our other candidates, incredible folks like Nima Mashouf, Eve Paclet, François Choquette, Brigitte Sanssouci. We had lots of incredible candidates that I wish would have been joining me in Ottawa because they would have been great voices for their communities and would have done a really good job fighting for them.